Good day everyone, this is Erwin Angelo V. Baduria. In this video, we will be discussing the integral of trigonometric functions. To start with, we have to be familiarized first with the different integral of trigonometric functions including sine. So we have the integral of sine u du is equal to negative cosine u plus c. The integral of cosine u du is equal to sine u plus c up to the integral of cosecant u du, which is equal to ln of cosecant u minus cotangent u plus c. Now let's scrutinize the integral first. Let's start with the integral of sine. So we have the integral of sine u du is equal to negative cosine u plus c. So at this point, we have to always check if the derivative of your u is always provided in the integrand, which is du. If the whole derivative of u is not provided in the integrand, you cannot directly transform it to negative cosine u. But if the derivative of u is all provided in the integrand, including its unwanted factor or a numerical factor, then you can directly transform it to negative cosine u. Then you have to add an arbitrary constant c. Now let's take a look at the integral of cosecant u cotangent u du, which is equal to negative cosecant u plus c. Now your u at your cosecant and your u at your cotangent must be the same, and that your du here must be provided in the whole integrand before you can directly transform it to negative cosecant u plus c. If the derivative of u is not provided, you have to rewrite the whole integral in such a way that its derivative is provided in the whole integrand. Now let's start with this basic example. We have to integrate y is equal to the integral of sine 5x. So since this is sine, we have to look at the formula of the integral of sine here. That is, the integral of sine u du is equal to negative cosine u plus c. Thus, we have to determine first the value of our u. So our u here is 5x. And then, we have to check if our du is already provided in the integrand before we can transform it to negative cosine u. Thus, the derivative of u here is equal to 5 dx, and 5 dx is provided here. Thus, we can determine the integral of this sine 5x 5 dx as y equal to, since the derivative of our u is already provided in the integrand, then we can have a negative cosine u, our u is 5x, and then we have to add plus c. Let's have another example. So we have here y is equal to the integral of 2e raised to 2x second square e raised to 2x dx. So second square here, our formula is second square u du, which is equal to tangent u plus c. First thing to do is to check our u. Since this is second square u, our u is e raised to 2x. Then let's have the derivative of our u is 2e raised to 2x dx. And then since our 2e raised to 2x and dx are here, then we can rewrite it into y equal to the integral of second square of e raised to 2x. And our du is 2e raised to 2x dx. As you can see, our 2e raised to 2x and dx are both provided in our integrand. Therefore, we can now rewrite our y into its specific value, which is tangent u. Thus, this is tangent u is e raised to 2x plus c. Let's have another example. So we have to integrate the derivative of phi with respect to alpha, which is equal to 6 alpha squared tangent 2 alpha cubed. Now in this case, we will be using tangent u, since we have tangent u here. Tangent u du is equal to ln secant u plus c. But before we can integrate this, we have to cross multiply first d alpha to the right side of the equation. It will give us d phi equal to 6 alpha square tangent of 2 alpha cube d alpha. Now we can now integrate both sides of the equation. So we have the integral of d phi equal to the integral of 6 alpha square tangent of 2 alpha cube d alpha. The integral of d phi is phi equal to the integral of 6 alpha square tangent of 2 alpha cube d alpha. Now, the right side of the equation is the integral of a certain integrand wherein we have tangent u. So we have our u here is equal to 2 alpha cube, and then our du is equal to 6 alpha square d alpha. As you can see, our 6 alpha square and d alpha is provided in the integrand. Therefore, we can directly transform this into ln secant u. Thus, our phi now is going to be equal to ln of secant u is 2 alpha cube plus c. Now let's have another example. D omicron, the derivative of omicron with respect to epsilon is equal to epsilon raised to 4 secant 2 epsilon raised to 5. Now we have to cross multiply the epsilon. It will give us D omicron is equal to epsilon raised to 4 secant of 2 epsilon raised to 5 d epsilon. We can now integrate both sides of the equation. The integral of d omicron is equal to the integral of epsilon raised to 4 secant of 2 epsilon raised to 5 d epsilon. The integral of d omicron is omicron, and that is equal to the integral of epsilon raised to 4 secant of 2 epsilon raised to 5 d epsilon. Now we can set our value, the value of u, as 2 epsilon raised to 5. So we are here, secant u du. Since this is just secant u, it is different from secant square u. Okay, so our u here is 2 epsilon raised to 5. Our du is 10 epsilon raised to 4 d epsilon. As you observe, our d epsilon is provided in the integrand, and e raised to 4 is also there, but our 10 is not provided in the integrand. So we have to write 10 here in such a way that it will balance the whole integral equation. So we can rewrite it as omicron equal to the integral of secant u. Our secant u is secant 2 epsilon raised to 5, and then du, our du is 10 epsilon raised to 4 d epsilon. Since the derivative of secant u, u, is already provided in the integrand here, we can now integrate, change it into ln secant u plus tangent u. But there should be 1 over 10 here in order to balance the whole integral equation, that is 10 times 1 is 10 divided by 10 is 1. Any number multiplied by 1 is the same as the original function. So therefore, we can now have omicron equal to 1 over 10. And the integral of this secant u du is ln secant u plus tangent u plus c. So we have here times ln of secant u, which is 2 epsilon raised to 5, plus tangent u, which is 2 epsilon raised to 5, and then plus c. Or we can write this as omicron equal to ln of secant 2 epsilon raised to 5 plus tangent of 2 epsilon raised to 5 over 10 as the whole denominator plus c. Another example here, so we have the derivative of omega with respect to psi is equal to square root of psi square cosecant 2 psi cube cotangent 2 psi cube. So we have to cross multiply d psi to the right side of the equation. It will give us d omega equal to square root of 3 psi square cosecant of 2 psi cube cotangent of 2 psi cube d psi. And then we can now integrate both sides of the equation. It will become the integral of d omega, and the right side is the integral of square root of 3 psi square cosecant 2 psi cube cotangent 2 psi cube d psi. So the integral of d omega is omega equal to, I think I have to rewrite this first. So we have integral of square root of 3 psi square cosecant of 2 psi cube cotangent of 2 psi cube d psi. And then I have to set my u. I am in this formula. Integral of cosecant u cotangent u du. And that is equal to negative cosecant u plus c. So I have here my cosecant u and cotangent u. So my u is 2 psi cube. And du is equal to 6 psi square d psi. As you observe, psi square is here, and then d psi is here. But square root of 3 is just a factor, so I can move it out of the integral sign. And then I have to balance the equation by 6 as unwanted factor. Therefore, I can rewrite this into omega equal to square root of 3 integral of cosecant 2 psi cube and then cotangent 2 psi cube and then followed by my du. Since this is cosecant u cotangent u, my du now is 6 psi square d psi. But since 6 is not provided in the original equation, I have to balance the equation by 6 and put 1 over 6 outside. So this is over 6. Therefore, I can now rewrite the whole integrand as negative cosecant u. Why? Because cosecant u and cotangent u, and then its du is provided in the whole integrand. Therefore, the final answer must be omega equal to square root of 3 over 6 times negative cosecant u. Our u is 2 psi cube plus c. And then I can multiply this negative outside with a positive square root of 3. It could be simplified into negative square root of 3 over 6 times cosecant of 2 psi cube plus c. For your practice, you may answer the following items. If you have any question, do not hesitate to beep my inbox. Thank you and have a good day.